Michigan's wineries and microbreweries have seen considerable growth over the past decade. Now Michigan distillers are starting to show up on the scene as well. Michigan State University, with the cooperation of the Michigan Brewing Company, is helping new spirit makers get started.
Well, basically, we're able to make essentially any distilled spirit that you can name, and that means whiskey, rum, brandy, any type of vodka, absinthe if you want, gin. We do all those different types of products. And so we have a selection of stills that let us do that. We're the only academically based program in the United States that has stills of this size that operate under commercial licenses. And so there's this sort of catch-22 for new people entering the field, where they're not allowed to do anything because you cannot distill any spirits whatsoever without a license. There's no personal exclusion like there is for beer and wine. And so in order to produce your product, you have to have a license. In order to have the license, you have to have the distillery. So how do you ever develop a product to show your investors and the bank and anybody else that you know how to do that?
So Berglund says the Distilled Beverage Technology Lab takes an entrepreneur's ideas and turns it into a marketable product.
We have one company we worked with that just came in and had the idea they wanted to make a vodka. And we said, what vodka? And they said, we don't know. So we I felt a little bit like Dorothy in the Broom here. So we sent them off on a quest, and we said, go to the liquor store and buy, you know, 5 or 8 different vodkas, taste them all, and tell us what you'd like yours to be most like, because there's a wide range of things. And when they told us, then we said, well, okay, if we want to do that, the thing that's probably makes the most sense is something like wheat. But in that case, they didn't really, when they first came in, they didn't have the slightest idea.
Berglund and his team can make between 5,000 and 10,000 cases of spirits a year, which lets the startups get a foot in the door before they have to invest in the equipment themselves. He says he gets several calls a week from potential micro distillers.
We have 15 projects underway right now here so far this year. Most of them are in Michigan, when we're in different elements of them. So we feel like we've been a really big resource for both the state and particularly the whole United States even in that respect. So we get requests for assistance from all over the country and actually provinces of Canada as well.
For WKAR Public Media, I'm Rob South with Reworking Michigan.